So what we said in the monohybrid grass, in monohybrid grass, we just said about that mono means single. What is single? Character is single. Here, die. What is die? Die means two characters. That means there are two characters we have to take over. That we say dihybrid. So here also, the character and allelic forms. Like monohybrid grass, the character and allelic forms need to be taken over. Then first of all, let me take the characters here. As usual, the Mendel selected Pisum sativum, as I said to you, in the monohybrid grass. That for that, I am taking the seed color and seed shape. Seed shape and seed color. What are the seed shape and seed color? Seed color and seed shape are character. Do remember, they are character. Okay. So for these characters, what are present? Allelic forms are present. How many allelic forms are there? That in case of Pisum sativum, the Mendel observed that every character is having only two allelic forms. It facilitated Mendel to experimentize easily. Okay, so let us see here. Round and wrinkle. Seed shape, round and wrinkle. He observed two alternative forms, two allelic forms. For shape, round and wrinkle. Seed color, yellow and green. Okay. Seed color, yellow and green. Okay. So that the round and wrinkle. Here even I am saying here, how do we represent them in the form of genes? And already Mendel did this experiment. So that's why we know these are the dominant characters. Yellow will be represented like this. Okay, so I'm straight away, I'm giving here. That means to avoid the confusion, then green will be like this. Round will be like this. Wrinkle will be like this. That because Mendel did this experiment already. He crossed among the round and wrinkle, two in the two allelic forms. Who is the dominant one? Round is the dominant one. So respective genotypes will be taken in the name of round and that letters only in the small. Respective yellow is the dominant over that. How do we come to know yellow is the dominant? Mendel did this experiment already. So that's why no need to do this from the beginning. Just I'm showing this for you. So let us talk about the dihybrid graph. Dihybrid here. Do remember, we are doing two characters. Two characters we are doing. The approach which I'm going will be definitely helpful for you to understand the Mendel clearly. So but just the class to class, there is a huge practice required that I am expecting that practice from you. That's all. Okay, now, so that means you need to learn that particular letter. So this is LO, round seeded plant. Okay, so let me write here. Let me write here. The LO and round seeded plant. A pure LO round seeded plant crossed with a pure green wrinkle seeded plant. So I already gave that the meanings for these particular abbreviations to you. L round and green wrinkle. That in the Pisum sativum, that there is a one more speciality is there. One more speciality, that yellow color seed is round in shape. Yellow color seed is round in shape. Okay, that is the first thing. Yellow color seed is round in shape and green color seed is wrinkle in shape. Okay, so that I am showing here. This is actually in the nature. That means before Mendel do experiment, what kind of seeds are present here? That what kind of seeds he expected? What you can see there, that this is the seed. And this is another seed. So yellow color seed is always round in shape. You see, this is round in shape. And green color seed is wrinkled in shape. Okay, I have to draw. I need to make it wrinkle, isn't it? So that green color is wrinkled in shape. Yeah, we'll make it wrinkle. The green color is wrinkle. Okay, so this is wrinkle. So this is actually the condition in nature. Okay. So that, as we know, the Pisum sativum is only going for self-pollination. That means that these kind of plants will go with pollination with them only. These kind of plants will go for pollination with them only. Okay, so Mendel cross did actually. Mendel did this cross. That what do you say this cross? Artificial cross pollination. Artificial cross pollination. Let me take the gametes here. Let me take the gametes from these two. That we can take one because they are similar type. From these two, we are taking one. Gamete means haploid in status, isn't it? The two gene presents diploid, and this is haploid. Slowly, one after one will come in detail for you. So this is another gametes here. What these are gametes. So what we are doing? We are doing artificial cross pollination. That is very important. You people need to remember. We are doing artificial cross pollination. So first of all, try to sing the issues in mind. That what is that? What we are doing in the parent generation? Artificial cross pollination we are doing. Okay. So just try to fix the things in the mind first of all. So what are the things we say? This is yellow round. This is yellow round. And this is green and wrinkled. You say yellow round and green and wrinkled. So that is very important for you to remember. Okay. So just let me show you that yellow round and green wrinkle. So I'm trying to do this with alphabets clearly for visible, for making to understand. So I'm writing here. So what is this? Yellow round crossed with green and wrinkle. Small y, green, smaller. Wrinkle. So you need to understand them separate. Okay. So after that, in the gamete level, so what we are taking? Capital Y and capital R. Capital Y, capital R. Here. Small y. Small y represents what? Small y represents green. Small r represents wrinkle. That things you need to get in mind. That is very important. Small y, small r. What these are? These are all gametes. Okay, so we said these are gametes. What next? What next? So let me show you. This is here gametes for this. What next? Artificial cross pollination. So what we'll get with artificial cross pollination? That heterozygous yellow round seeded plants are appearing. Okay, let me show you. That heterozygous, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. So what is this? This is F1 generation. This is termed as F1. Okay, this is termed as F1 generation. So in F1 generation, what are appeared? That heterozygous, from here, you just remember this, heterozygous, yellow. For yellow color, heterozygous. For seed shape, heterozygous round, heterozygous yellow, heterozygous round seeded plants are appeared. So that what we are taken here up to only the first generation. So we know this is parental generation. Let me write here parents, P1, parent generation. Okay, so from here you just need to remember like this. A homozygous yellow round, homozygous yellow round, homozygous yellow, homozygous round. We need to say both here. Homozygous yellow, homozygous round. Why? That to say it as pure, we need to show you homozygous yellow, homozygous round. Homozygous green, homozygous wrinkle. Homozygous yellow round, homozygous yellow round seeded plant are crossed with homozygous green wrinkle seeded plant in the first generation. What we obtain? We obtain heterozygous yellow, heterozygous round seeded plants are obtained. Okay. What next? As usual, what we did in monohybrid cross, we do the same. What is that? That self-pollination of the F1 generation means F1 need to be crossed with F1. F1 need to be crossed with F1. That means heterozygous yellow round seeded plants are crossed with heterozygous yellow round seeded plants are self-pollinated with them only. Heterozygous yellow round. Okay. Heterozygous yellow round seeded plants need to be crossed with heterozygous yellow round. Here the taking gametes is going to be that complex issue here. So that's why I'm giving a small technique for you. A small technique. You see, you take the four letters in a box, capital Y, small y, capital R, smaller. In future, various problems we have to do. So there also you can apply the same technique. That's it. We'll take one. We'll take one first. 1, 3, 1, 4. Why not 1, 2? Both are belongs to same character, isn't it? So gametes. Next, we'll take 2. Here it is. We'll take 2, 2, 3, 2, 4. Okay, so let me write 1, 3. Capital Y, capital R. 1, 4. Capital Y, small r. 1, 2, 3. Small y, capital R. 2, 4. Small y, small r. Okay, in the same way. Here also the same, isn't it? Here also the same. Capital Y, capital R. Capital Y, small r. Small y, capital R. Small y, small r. Same gametes. Okay. So that means actually that various ways they use to say that like this capital Y, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital R, capital Y, small r, small y, capital R, small y, small r. These lines will confuse you. That's why I'm saying you just go through my technique here. 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4. Or else if you want to think logically, even you can think logically. What is this? These are all gametes, isn't it? In the gamete, complete representation required, isn't it? How many characters we are taken? We are taken 2 characters. One is seed color and other is seed shape, isn't it? So in our gametes, both should represent seed color, seed shape. Seed color, seed shape. Shape, whatever it means. Seed color, seed shape. Okay. That means if I take a gamete like this, is it possible? Such kind of gamete? No. Here both are exhibiting seed color only. So that's why that will be wrong. So that's in that way you have to remember. Okay. Otherwise, non-logical remembrance only for IP. So what we can say? So you just remember like this. 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4. We got the gametes now. We got the gametes. Okay. So what we do with these gametes? We'll draw the Punnett square board. Let's draw the Punnett square board. That putting the heading F2 generation. And I'm making a bigger square board for you to accommodate all that particular things we did. Okay. So, okay, let me draw once again to make our comfort. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have to write our taken gametes. Okay, so one side we are taking the male gametes, capital Y, capital R, capital Y, small r, small y, capital R, small y, small r. We need to show this particular gametes very clearly. That is very important for us. Capital Y, capital R, the one side male gametes, the other side female gametes. Capital Y, small r, small y. Like this, you may have some confusion sometimes. But do remember that both are representing same color, isn't it? So that's why definitely that is wrong. You should understand in that manner. If you remember logically, that will be easy to you. Small y, capital R, small y, small r. So the gametes which are formed in the F1, I just took these particular gametes into the box, Punnett square. What we did in monohybrid, the same idea, but this is the bigger one. We are taking 2 characters, isn't it? That's why it was, we got bigger here. What to do? So we need to practice this. I am writing capital Y, this one and this one. Capital Y, capital Y. Both means, first of all, we need to take the seed color. Then after seed shape. Capital R, capital Y. Okay. So capital Y, capital Y. Capital R, capital R. So then in the same way, here this is. Okay. That will make it neat and clear. Okay. So then capital Y, this capital Y and this capital Y. And capital R, small r. Capital Y, small y, capital R, capital. And I request you people to need to write what is that also. Okay, let me fill first of all, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. Then here, these two, that means this area and this box, you need to fill. Capital Y, capital R, small r. Next, capital Y, small r, small r. You people need to show the difference between the capital Y and small y clearly as I am doing so. Otherwise, you will be confused over. So, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. Capital Y, small r, small r. Okay. Next, this capital Y, small y, capital R, capital R. Next, capital Y, capital R, small r. Then small y, capital R. Then small y, capital R, small r. I think you know, you make, at least you are understanding what I am doing exactly. So first of all, you need to write the capital letter, wherever it is, here, or here, wherever. The capital Y, capital R, small r. Okay, so then capital Y, small r. Small y, capital R, small r. Small y, small r, small r. And do need to remember the basic here. What is this? The things I'll show you in the next screen. To fill these, what we need to know? What is this we need to know? What is this? What is this? Okay, what is this? Means homozygous round, heterozygous round. That in that way you need to know that, because that's why I'm coming from the beginning in that way only. So that's why I'll show you once again. Then after we'll fill that area. Okay. So what is this? What is this? This is homozygous yellow, isn't it? Homozygous yellow. We have to write this as homozygous yellow. And what is this? Heterozygous yellow. Heterozygous L. And this one, homozygous green. Homozygous green. Next, here it is. Okay, we'll see in the color for this. Let's take right. Homozygous round. Homozygous round. Okay. Next, heterozygous round. Then this is homozygous wrinkle. These are the participants in the movie. So that's why you people need to know what is what. Okay, at least that to make the phenotypic ratio, we know that these two are yellow, isn't it? These two are yellow. This is yellow and this is green. And these two are round. Okay, round. That means phenotypically, physical expression point of view, that two are round. Okay, what is this? This is wrinkle. Okay. So that means let us write the phenotypical information here. Let us write the phenotypical information. That after that we have to go for genotypical. Then what is this? What is this? Yellow round, isn't it? Yellow round. Okay. So let me write little upper, that it will be better for me. Which I can show you. Okay, if you write, it will be overlap. Yeah, okay, no problem. Even overlap, I think you better can understand. So what is this? You can say, what is this? This is also yellow round. Okay. So you can help me actually. What is this? The third box I am talking. Third box. What is this? Yellow round seeded plant. Okay, the fourth box. Yellow round. Okay, the fourth box, that is also yellow round. Next, box number five. Yellow round. Okay, the box number five, yellow round. Now in the box number 6, yellow wrinkle. What is this? Yellow wrinkle. Next, box number 7. Box number 7, yellow round. Okay, box number 7, yellow round. Next, box number 8. You need to fill all these things. Box number 8, see that. What is this? Yellow wrinkle. Box number 8, yellow wrinkle. This recognition required only the basic information which I shown to you, which I shown to you in the next on the screen. As I said to you, you need to remember capital Y, capital Y, small y. Both are yellow, phenotypical. Then small y, green. Then capital R, capital R, capital R, small r. They are round. Small r, that is wrinkle. If you remember this, filling this will be so easy. Okay, box number 9 I am talking. So see how I am giving the number. This is the way actually. Because why we should go like this? That is given by Mendel. This is the total experiment. I am talking about Mendel. So that one is the box number 9. Box number 9 is yellow round. Box number 9 is yellow round. Okay. There's box number 10 is again yellow round. So that is again aileron. Okay, now next, box number 11. Yeah, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, what is this? That is new, green and round. The green and round. Okay, that is green and round. Next, the box number 12. Green and round. That is green and round. Okay. Next. So then box number 13. Yellow round. Yellow round. Okay. For that you have to use the red color. Next. Box number 14. In the box number 14, what is there? Yellow wrinkle. Yellow wrinkle. Okay, so yellow wrinkle. Box number 14. Box number 15. What is it? Green and round. Green and round. Okay, so that's it. Green and round. Okay, next. Box number 16. What is it? Green and wrinkle. Green and wrinkle. Okay, that was green, full green, green and wrinkle. So this is the condition. In F2 generation, what is this exactly? Then when F1 plants are self-pollinated, when F1 plants are self-pollinated, we got the gametes like this, and these are the gametes, and these gametes are, that for our comfort, we used the Punnett square board to understand them clearly. We used the Punnett square board, and we made a complete box here. And in this box, let us count phenotypic ratio. First of all, how many yellow round seeded plants are appearing? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So how many yellow round seeded plants are appearing? 9. Let us write that 9 here. Let us write phenotypic ratio. Mendel F2 phenotypic ratio. In that, the first one, yellow round seeded plants. Yellow round seeded plants. How many are appeared? 9. Next, let's count. Yellow wrinkle. Yellow wrinkle. So here it is. 1, 2, 3 are appeared. Okay. So, how many are appeared here? 3. Mm-hmm. Let me write. Yellow wrinkle. Okay, so three plants are appearing. Next, green round. We need to search for the green round. So how many green round are appeared? One, two, and three. The green round seeded plants are appearing. Okay, so there's green round seeded plants. Three. Next, green and wrinkle seeded plants. So how many green and wrinkle seeded plants are appeared? One. You can see the last box, that green and wrinkle seeded plants. Okay, so that's it. That's it what we got. That nine L round seeded plants, I'll show you once again what we did. I'll show you once again. These are the results we got actually. That when we do cross of these, that L round, L wrinkle, green round, and green wrinkle. When we did the cross, so nine L round and nine L round and three L wrinkle and three green round and one green wrinkle seeded plants are appeared. Finally, appeared finally. Okay, so that you need to remember. This graph you people need to practice again and again. Okay, so after that we have to go for multiple applications of the monohybrid and dihybrid graphs. Okay, so that practice required, and more practice makes us to get a complete idea. So this kind of practice required here. The final output is like this. L round 9, L wrinkle 3, green round and 3, green wrinkle 1. We are not doing a genotypic ratio today. Just let me about the phenotypic ratio. That's enough here. How to do the genotypic ratio, I'll explain tomorrow. Okay, so then what we did till the time, let's take it out once again from the beginning. So L round seeded plant crossed with a green wrinkle seeded plant. A pure L round seeded plant is crossed with a green wrinkle seeded plant. What are appeared in the F1 generation? In the F1 generation, all the plants with yellow round seeded plants we got. Actually, yellow round seeded plants we got in F1 generation. Okay, so that means that they are dominant one, what you can see. Heterozygous L round seeded plant. When these heterozygous L round seeded plants are crossed with them, that means self pollination. When we did the self pollination, we got the gametes like this. We got the gametes like this. These are the gametes. Capital Y capital Y small r, small y capital R, small y small. And one side is the male gamete, other side is the female gamete. You need to understand. These are gametes. Gametes. So what we did then? We did that these gametes are taken into the Punnett square board. So when these gametes are taken into the Punnett square board, that we have to fill this. I'm giving work to you that you need to fill this. Capital Y, capital R, capital Y, small r. Small y, capital R, small y, small r. Here also, that one side will take the male gametes, other side female gametes. And we need to fill these and you should check like whether you got that L round and L wrinkle, green round and green wrinkle are appeared for you in the form of 9:3:3:1 or not. You have to check, you need to fill and you have to check. Okay, so this is a complete information about the Mendel dihybrid cross. And people, while doing this, this is a new one for you, isn't it? So that's why you remember this. What is this? Yellow, homozygous. It is yellow, heterozygous. This is green. Then homozygous, round, heterozygous, round, homozygous, wrinkle. If you remember this, that's no confusion will be raised. Okay, so by practicing this particular diagram, this particular issue will make us to be much better. Okay, then after we can go through the applications of the Mendel dihybrid graph. Mendel monohybrid graph. But first of all, that one should get perfection in the monohybrid and dihybrid graph. Okay, we'll do more practice and we'll go with the various kind how to do the neat problems and all that. these two are going to be the basics here for both monohybrid and dihybrid. Okay, so do remember that practice is the only solution for the genetic. So you practice this, and then in the next class we'll continue with the applications of the monohybrid and dihybrid. Okay, and